Hi, Alex here from rebellaper.com, and welcome back to this epic in-app purchases tutorial series where you can learn how to add in-app purchases to your iOS apps in Xcode 10, Swift 4.2, and iOS 12. And in this video, I am going to talk about how you can add non-consumables to your app. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, in the previous episode, I have shown you how you can add consumables to your iOS apps. But I had a little bit of leftover because I want to show you how you can add the number, well, basically the number of coins that you have purchased. And for that, we are going to need Rebeloper Store Pro. So, how do you get Rebeloper Store Pro? Well, it is pretty easy. Go ahead and go to our site and go to our store.rebeloper.com, and there, if you just scroll down, you will see that I have a Rebeloper Store, and go ahead and you can purchase it there. Now, once you do that, then you will have a new folder in your Rebeloper Store downloads, and that is Rebeloper Store Pro. Now, that is what we are going to drag and drop into our project now. And let me just go ahead and add it right over there. Okay, and maybe just switch places here. Now, you can see that there is a Rebeloper Store keychain account file, Rebeloper Store file, store setup, and models. Okay, we are going to go deep mostly on Rebeloper Store setup, but for now, do know that you need to basically add some new Cocoapods. And that is, let me just go here, and we are going to add them here. So let us just go back to our downloaded resources and open up this pod file again that you have. And you can see we have pods for Rebeloper Store Pro. So let us just copy this. We are going to have Keychain Swift and Bulletin Board, and you will see why we need these in the next videos. Okay, I'm just paste that in, go back to terminal, and again, type in pod install, or just have the up arrow tapped and you will get that command line. So as you can see, it is installing Bulletin Board and Keychain Swift, and it has been installed. Now, let's go back to our project. Great, let me just open this up again. And finally, we want to show how many coins there are in our app. Okay, for that, first of all, make sure that in the Rebeloper Store Pro, go to set Rebeloper Store setup, and reset keychain to default values is set to false. Now, if you, as I told you earlier, if you want to delete all of the current data of your app, then you should set this to true. Now it is set to false, that is great. So now we want to show the number of coins that we have acquired or purchased or we have on upon for first launch. So let's go to our views and headers and let's select our consumables header. And as you can see, here we have a populate down at the bottom of our file, and we are guardlet unwrapping the get virtual currency amount function, the return of that function. And basically what this does, it's a Rebeloper Store Pro function that gets all of our virtual currency amount. And we want to set the count label dot text to that amount. And while we are at it, let us just go to back to Rebeloper Store, and in Rebeloper Store Babe 6, let's enable some things in the extensions. First off, we want to enable Rebeloper Store keychain account dot setup, because once we start the Rebeloper Store, now we want to use the keychain. And for that, of course, we have installed the keychain Swift. Let's just scroll down a little bit, and we want to save the real purchases into Rebeloper Store keychain with our product ID. Well, I believe, yeah, I didn't go down there entirely. So this basically saves the purchase into the keychain. Okay, let's just scroll down if we do have anything left, and I believe that's it. Okay, now let's go and launch this on our iPhone and let's see what happens. Okay, let me just show you here. Okay, let's unlock it. Let's build and run again. Okay, and there you go. You can see we have our 1000 coins. Of course, in the previous video, we did buy, but we did not save it. If you want to use Rebeloper Store Basic, then you have the responsibility to save the number of coins that you have bought, where the user has bought, into keychain or NS user defaults or whatever you want. Now let's do that again. So let's buy a bag of coins again. Let's wait for it to be processed. There you go, your purchase was successful. Let's click on OK. And it hasn't been updated. It must have mean that we are missing some notifications. Let me just double check. Okay, we don't really have that shown up, so I have made a little debugging here. As you can see, we only have 1000 coins, but we have purchased some, and that is because we still need to have some more setup. Now, first of all, let's set the default data source. So from now on, you can use Rebeloper Store fetch purchases and for consumable, non-consumable, and so on. And we should have this in our notification observer too. Okay, now what you want to do now is basically say how much coins you want to add when one purchases. Okay, so that can be done in the Rebeloper Store setup. And if you just scroll down, you can see a section called Primary Virtual Currency Purchase ID. Now you want to add your IDs here, first of all. So let me just go there, Rebeloper Store. Okay, let's go and add that too. And here we have our virtual currency purchases. And here we have our first purchase and our second purchase. Now, the interesting part here is our virtual currency purchase amount, 30 and 60. I will leave that as it is. Okay, now let's try to build and run again, and hopefully this time we will get lucky. So that was the missing part of our setup. Let's just see here. Okay, here we go. Let's purchase. Let's buy. And it is processing it, and you are all set. Your purchase was successful, and if you can notice, the 30 coins have been added. Okay, let's test our chest of coins too. Let's buy, and we should get that. Yeah, we do get it. Okay, now that is it for in-app purchases of consumables. Now, one last thing, and we will wrap it up for today's lesson, and that is the restore purchases. Now let me just double check if we do have that in there, and let's see our consumables controller, and let's just scroll down because I remember that I do have it. Yes, Rebeloper Store. So let's just check if that works. Okay, let us just select QuickTime Player, and I am tapping on the restore purchases button, and there you go. So what you want to do is go to settings on your app and then sign out of your regular account and sign in with the sandbox test user that you have just created in App Store Connect, and then you can restore the purchases. Okay, that is it for consumables. And let's talk about non-consumables. So it is basically the same as setting up the consumables. So first up, let us just go to our App Store Connect account and let's select our app and let's create a non-consumable. And let's just see, let's just build and run our final project. Let's stop this and build and run. And I will create my first in-app purchase for our consumable. Let's see here. Here we go. It is a no ads non-consumable. So let's just create that in App Store Connect. And it is pretty simple. Go ahead and select your app. Then let's go to features and click on the plus button here, and it will be a non-consumable. Let's click on create. Reference name, no ads. Okay, and the product ID. Okay, now let's go back to Xcode and in Rebeloper Store config, if you can find it, here we have our first non-consumable, but, oh, and this is the store. Sorry for that. And let's go and select the Rebeloper Store starter. And inside here, you can see our first non-consumable, but we need to edit it. Okay, let's copy that out and let's go back to our Rebeloper Store setup and scroll all the way up. And you can see here, you can add your non-consumable IDs. So that's that for the first one. I will do the second one in my spare time and you should do that. Well, basically, let's just do that here. So consumable two. Okay, and let's just go and add this here for our non-consumable. And remember, this is a non-consumable, so make sure that under the kind, non-consumable is set up. And that's it for our project. Let's go back to Google Chrome and add this non-consumable product ID there. Great. Let's select our pricing. Let me just look here. It is under tier one. Display name, no ads, and description, remove all the ads from the app. Okay, here we go. Let's choose our file here. Of course, make sure that you will replace this later on. Okay, let's click on save. And let's create the second one, and that is for getting access, granting access for the go to next level, for the next level. Okay, let's go ahead and click on the plus button, another non-consumable. It will be real fast. Okay, unlock next level. Okay, let's paste that in with consumable 2, pricing, it is tier 2, unlock. Next level again, and maybe not with capital. Okay, and another in-app purchase template screen, and let's save that. Great. Now we have set up our in-app purchases in App Store Connect. Let's just wait for that, for finishing, and we are going to add some code in our Xcode. So without wasting too much time, let us just go into our non-consumables controller and just scroll through all of it. First of all, let us just, well, we will talk about go to next level in just a moment. First of all, let's commit our purchase as usual. So Rebeloper Store commit purchase, and I am grabbing the purchase as usual, as we did in our consumables controller. We are going to create our data source as usual. This time we are fetching purchases for our non-consumable. Okay, let's just scroll down. Again, we are fetching our data the same, and we are creating a section provider here. Then we are adding it to our compose provider. Then we are creating our compose provider as a header compose. Oh, sorry about that. Let me just uncomment that. We are creating our compose header provider. And as you can see, we don't have a populate just yet, but we will soon. And we are commenting out all of these codes too. Okay, and we are enabling restore purchases. So let's take a look at this populate. And that is inside our non-consumables header. Okay, and if you just scroll down, you will see that we can comment out this function. And I just realized that I have set up our in-app purchase for the no ads as consumable ones. So let me just change these IDs. So we are checking for our first product, for our non-consumable, and that is again in our Rebeloper Store setup, the non-consumable one, and that is set up as the no ads in App Store Connect. So let's just go back, and we are grabbing our product. Now this product needs for us to fetch our is product purchased inside our Rebeloper Store fetch purchase state for our product. Now if the purchase is the product is purchased, then we set the banner image view to 0 and we set the banner add status label to purchase. Banner add is removed, and you will see that in just a moment. And if not, then we set the banner add image view to 1, so we are showing an ad. Now what do we do when we want to check for the second product? Well, let's go back to the non-consumables controller. And if you just scroll all the way up, here we have go to next level. And basically we do the same thing. Let me just change this to product 2 because I have mismatched that. We are grabbing our product, checking if the product is purchased, and if it is, then we go to our next level. So let's build and run and see how all of this works. Okay, let's just wait for it. And hopefully we will be on time. Let's see. Let's select no ads. Let's buy. And you are all set. Your purchase was successful. And as you can see, the banner has disappeared and a label is appeared. Now, if you want to type in, we want to go to the next level. Let's tap on that. And it says you must purchase the unlocked next level to access this content. Okay. Now you can see that the in-app purchase, no ads, in-app purchase has disappeared. Now let's buy our unlocked next level. Okay. Let's buy, and once we buy, we should be able to get access to the next level. Great. Now that is it for non-consumables. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.